Hey guys, Coach Sean here on this Wednesday morning, and every Wednesday we're going to do what's going to be called Mobility Wednesday. So it's going to be a 10 to 15 minute workout. It'll be targeting different things each week. Today's session is just going to be all about mobility, the total body. We're going to start on the ground, work our way up, then work our way back down to the ground, 10, 15 minutes, loosen everything out. The way I say that makes it sound like it's going to be easy, not necessarily so. It's going to feel like a good workout, but just at a nice, modest pace, and do what you can, the exercises, and yeah, that's pretty much it. So every Wednesday, we're gonna have a different mobility session, and then in the evenings at 5 o'clock online on Facebook and my YouTube channel, we're gonna have more of a HIIT session, high intensity interval session. We're gonna push a little bit more. So there will be one today on at 5 o'clock, and it won't actually have burpees this week, so give it a go, see how you get on, if you feel okay after this session. With that said, we're going to go straight into it. So we're going to start off down the ground. It's called handcuffs. We're going to work on our upper back. So hands out in front. We're going to lift our hands up off the ground. Pull, slowly rotate them right back in. Pull the shoulder blades back. We're going to go for 10. Keep your head down in 3, 2, 1. Hands up. Slowly back in. Pull the shoulder blades back. And relax. Back out again. And back, in, and out. That's it, nice and easy. 8 more to go. Probably should have picked the first exercise when my head is knocked straight down into the ground. And right back out. Perfect, keeping this going. That's it, get a good squeeze in the shoulder blades. We got 5 left to go. Perfect. And right back out. Last 4. That's it. Keep it going. 3. And back. 2. Keep the hands up as high as you can off the ground. Back in. Last 1. And right. Perfect. Like I said at the start, we're going to stay down the ground, work well to a stand position, then right back down again. So what we're going to do, we're going to go down low into a plank, hold for 30 seconds, in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. I don't have to watch. You're ready to use this. So hold now, the core nice and tight. If we start to struggle, keep the feet a little bit wider than normal, or drop down to our knees, do the exact same thing. We've got less than 20 seconds though, so if we're still holding, try and hold it out. Excellent, keep it going. You got 10 more seconds. That's it, keep holding, keep holding. Final 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Perfect, a little bit of activation for our core. What we're gonna do is loosen out the hips. What we're gonna do is call it frog stretch. So out on all fours, feet wide and shoulder width, knees wide and shoulder width, keep the back straight. Hands directly underneath our chest, and we're just going to push the hips back, keep that back straight. We should feel that on the inside of our legs, and out. And back again, and out. Perfect, keep it going. Sitting back into it, and out. And back. 6 left. And back. 5. And back. 4. That's it. Last 3. Just loosen up those hips. Going for 2. Back and 1. Right back in and out. Okay, what we're on the next press up position. You're going to bring 1 foot as close as you can to our hand. You're going to push the elbow down, up, and twist through. Okay, so go bend the hips, a little bit in the thoracic region, the upper back region. Start in 3, 2, 1. Keep the back leg straight, elbow down, up, and twist. Definitely feel the back side as well as you twist through. That's it, up, and now. 3, 2, last one, and up. Okay, this leg head that's out in the front, we're going to bring our shin on the ground, knee across, and try and bring our chest over like so. Okay, so bring the heel up as high as you can. As you see, I'm struggling with my own flexibility at the moment. But we're going to sit right down onto it. We should feel a stretch all along here. Sit down, hold that. It's called a pigeon stretch. Now, a lot of exercises like this, if we stick with this over the next couple of weeks, we'll start to improve our mobility, our flexibility, decreasing our risk of injury as well. Okay, and relax. Now, we're going to go to the opposite side, do the exact same thing. So, up to the leg out, back leg straight, elbow down, look, going for 8 and 3, 2, 1, down, and up. Down, and up. Keeping it going. That's it, get the elbows close to the candy ground, keep that front foot flat as well. Last 3. 2, 1, perfect. Okay, one leg across, sitting down again onto it, nice and low. That's it, should feel a stretch out along here. Get our heel up higher if we can, sitting right down into the stretch. That's it, hold it there. Right down low, we're going to go for another 10 seconds. And 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Okay, so we're slowly working our way up onto our feet. What we're going to do next is we're going to hold a squat down nice and low, we're going to stretch pretty much the groin region just over to one side and back over. We're going to go for 30 seconds, starting in 3, 2, 1, low squat, wider stance than normal squat, over and back, over and back. That's it. Let's lean right down, side to side. If we can't keep that back as straight, you can't sit down into it. If not, just have the hands down by our legs, or even on our legs, over and back. Try not to stand up. Stay down low for 3, 2, 1. And that was a little bit longer, 3 seconds, but we'll get used to that. What we're going to do next, the easier version is to keep one knee on the ground, hands up, hold back. What's slightly harder is to hold that knee up off the ground. We're going to go for 20 seconds, standing together in 3, 2, 1. If we can, leg up, hold out from there. Keep that back straight, pull back. So it's probably the toughest exercise to do today. Like I said, we're struggling. Just have that knee down. We're pushing here, getting a good stretch here. Right back down, making it challenging. Knee up off the ground for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and relax. Excellent, what gets done in one leg must be done in the other. So up to leg, doing the exact same thing in 3, 2, 1, and let's go. So slightly up, pull those shoulder blades back, keep it going for 10 more seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and slowly right back down. That's it, that's the hardest one. We're up on our feet now, so what we're going to do is slowly work our way right back down. We're going to have 5 exercises left, and that's going to be our Wednesday morning mobility session. So what we're going to do, keep the back leg straight, hands down. We are going to bend a little bit of our flexibility and mobility is not that great, but try and keep them as straight as we can. Walk out, walk back in. 3, 2, 1, so leg straight, walk the hands out, walking back in. And out. And in. And out. In. 4 left to go. 3, 2, 1. So we're going to work our way back down. Before we do, we're just going to get a small bit of a cardio going. So we're going to use 20 seconds, just nice and easy into our jumping jacks. If we struggle, just step it out a little bit slowly. So we're going to go 3, 2, 1. Just nice and easy. Just on our toes. We're not trying to push ourselves too hard right now. That comes later when we do the HIIT session at 5 o'clock today. So just nice and easy for 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, well, we're going to now down to a squat pulse just for 20 seconds. In 3, 2, 1. So we're working our way back down. Keep the back straight, shoulder blades back, sit right down into it. Push the knees and feet out wide as well. Don't have them drop in. Keep it going for 10 more seconds. So we're working a small bit of swell. Maybe it's just hot outside. 5, 4, 3, 2, and relax. Once again, go slightly longer than 20 seconds, but I'm sure you're not complaining. Down low, second last exercise. So what we're gonna do, have our hands down, keep the shoulder blades in the ground, one knee up, two knees up, twist them over to one side, hold for a split second, over the opposite side, the exact same thing. In 3, 2, 1, over, hold, opposite side. So we can bring the hips up off the ground, but try not to bring our shoulder blades up off the ground. So over, that's this. Just hold for a split second. Excellent. That's it, keep it going. Almost there. We're on 7. I'm pretty sure of me. And back. Last training side. And back. 2. And back. Last one. And back. Okay. And relax. Last thing we're going to do. Feet shoulder width, lying down on the ground, twist our pelvis, so basically our low back's flat on the ground, and we're going to bring ourselves up one vertebrae at a time into a glute bridge. On 3, 2, 1, up one vertebrae at a time, nice and slowly up, and right back down, as if we're peeling our back up and down, off the ground. That's it, perfect, keep it going. We've got 8 more to go, and we're done. That's it, keep it going. Last 6, just take our time. If we do feel any sort of a pull at all in our lower back, just stop the exercise. Rest up from there. You probably need to get a couple of good stretches on, if not see someone out there. Last 4. And that is such a terrible note to end this on. Keep it going. 3. And that's it, up. And last 2. And down. Last 1, up. Down. And relax. Awesome. Well done today, guys. That is our Wednesday mobility session in the bag. We're going to have a different mobility session next Wednesday at 10 a.m. as well. But before then, we will have a session at 5 o'clock today, a HIIT session. So a little bit higher in the intensity. If you want to get a warm-up in, do this video again 15 minutes beforehand. Just to get another quick warm-up in. It doesn't harm to get an extra mobility session in. And every Friday as well, we're going to have Finisher Friday, just something unique to add on to your workouts at the end of the week. And that's it from me, from Coach Sean. Take care.